Now we are going to see the Carnot's principles, or rather say, in many books it is written by Carnot theorem. So Carnot's principle or Carnot theorem, whatever you say, two principles are there. I am going to first elaborate the first one. The principle is stating like this: efficiency of an irreversible heat engine, mind it, efficiency of an irreversible heat engine, which is not reversible, is always less than that of a reversible engine between the same thermal reservoir. This is the condition. If, in easy words, if two heat engine, one is reversible, one is irreversible, they are working under same thermal reservoir, that means source and sink, they are same, then obviously all the time reversible heat engine must have more efficiency than the irreversible heat engine. That is the first Carnot theorem. If you want to prove it, then suppose this is a block diagram where you can see a source is T1, a sink is T2, EA is a heat engine which is irreversible one, and EB is a heat engine which is reversible one. So both of these heat engine working under same source and sink. Okay, now I have missed that work part, WA, and it is WB. Now EA, the irreversible heat engine, having a heat flow of Q1A and having a rejection of Q2A, as a result of that work is produced, which is WA. And similarly, reversible heat engine having a heat flow Q1B and heat rejection Q2B, as a result of that net work WB is produced. Okay, that thing I have written over here, whatever I told now. Now I have to, if we want to prove that the efficiency of EB, that is the reversible one, is more than the efficiency of EA. So if you want to prove it, then the condition is that so what do we want to prove? We want to prove efficiency of EB is more, obviously we are talking about the thermal efficiency, EA. We want to prove this. Okay, so first we should consider that, let us assume, we should go in a reverse way actually. Let us assume it is not true. That means the statement is not true, whatever given in the Carnot's theorem, it is not true. If I prove the reverse one, then obviously we will come with the same standpoint. Okay, let us assume it is not true, means this statement is not true. So what does this mean? That means efficiency of A, that means the irreversible one, or rather say efficiency of EA, is greater than the efficiency of EB. Just the reverse of this one. Okay, first we are assuming this statement is a false one, wrong one. So if it is a wrong one, then obviously the efficiency of the irreversible heat engine will be greater than the efficiency of a reversible heat engine. Okay, this statement is true. It is true. We are assuming so. Now see that, is this statement is really true or not? If after having a kind of discussion, if we find that this statement is actually not true, then obviously the reverse one is true. That means this one is true. Okay, so we are going in a reverse way actually. So here you can see that the source is same. So obviously the amount of heat flow to the heat engine 1 and EA and EB, they are actually same. That means we can say that if the source is same, so I can say Q1A obviously will be Q1B. I can assume it like a Q1. Okay, so Q1 heat is, same amount of heat is coming to EA and EB also. So since whatever we have considered, that eta EA is greater than eta eb. Now we have assumed like so. Let's check is it what it gives us. So efficiency means we know that, in short, I can write eta a, huh? Because ea lots of substitute values are coming, and eta b, so it will be small one. So efficiency is nothing but net worth to the heat supply, that is q1a. q1a is nothing but q1, so I can write like this q1a, and eta b is nothing but the work done net worth to the q1b. That relations actually we know from our previous lectures. Okay, network to the heat supply. Already I have explained that Q1A and Q1B is nothing but Q1. So while this both of these heat transfer, actually if they are same in amount or same in magnitude, then they can be cancelled with each other. So that way WA greater than WB. So what does this give? That is giving us that work produced by the engine A or irreversible heat engine will be greater than the work produced by the reversible heat engine, that is EB. We find this one. Okay. Now we have to draw a combined heat engine. That means we are going to combine both of these heat engines. Already we have done this earlier. Now if we combine this both of these engines, so what it actually looks, suppose this is our EA and this is our EB. Okay, arrow should be there. We are going to combine both of these engines like this way. So already I have seen, I have shown you people that WA, that is the work produced by the engine A, it is more than the work produced by the engine B. So suppose this is the output of engine A, WA, that is the output of the engine A, okay, and it is going to feed to the engine B, because more amount, some excess amount of work is produced in engine A. So that work is going to feed to the engine B also. So if WA is greater than the WB, so some amount of excess work will be there. That is the excess work, that is the magnitude of WA minus WB, because WA is more than WB. So after supplying to the work, supplying the work to EB, some excess heat will be remain there. It's a kind of excess work that is coming out as a net work. Okay, and basically both of these engine is working with the same sink. So it is, suppose our sink of a temperature of T2, so both of them rejecting some heat to the sink. Okay, so it is Q2A and it is Q2B. Now obviously this QB will produce some work that was named as Q1B, so this is the Q1B, it is producing rejecting some heat. Oh sorry, these arrows should be in this direction now. Wait. So while that heat engine is working EB, obviously it has some work flow inside of it. Okay, so Q2B is going in. As a result of that, it is a reversible heat engine, so I should name it like this EB, so it will be more better to understand. I can reverse this symbol like this way. Okay, so now it is clear, it is reversible one. Okay, so reversible heat engine is getting a heat of Q2 be supplied to it as a result. So while it is reversible, then obviously it is working like a heat pump or refrigerator, whatever you can assume. So it is having a heat flow to it, and after rejecting the heat, so it will produce, or heat rejection will be there. Now what amount of heat is rejecting it? If you will supply that heat to the irreversible heat engine like this way, I am naming it by Q1A. Now you can see the amount of work is supplied to the reversible heat engine, that is WB. Okay, so obviously it is now working like a heat pump or refrigerator, so that way it is having a heat extraction from the sink, and the heat rejection, it is Q1B. That Q1B is going to feed to the irreversible heat engine. So while the irreversible heat engine working, so it needs some heat flow to the supply, so that heat is supplying from reversible heat engine. That way I am eliminating the source. You can see we don't need any source over there. If the source temperature on T1, it is not needed now. Before of that, why we haven't combined both of them? They are working between two thermal reservoirs, one source of T1, one sink of T2. Now while I am combining both of them, then you can see the source need is actually not there. If we eliminate the source from there, still both of these reversible and irreversible heat engine in combined manner, they are working very nicely, isn't it? Because reversible heat engine having a heat flow from the sink, I should symbol in reverse like this. So it is extracting heat from sink and rejecting some heat, and the rejection of heat is going to feed to the irreversible heat engine. So irreversible heat engine also having a heat flowing, then as a result of that, it will, the Q2A will be in this direction, so some heat rejection must be there. Yes, as a result of that, some work will be produced by irreversible heat engine. So WA is more than WB, so WB is given to that, and some, after giving WB, some excess amount will be there, that is WA minus WB, that is the net work. So now this way, after eliminating the source from there, still both of these heat engine in a combined manner, they are working nicely, isn't it? So the magnitude of heat and work quantities will remain same while the EV is reversed. While the EV is reversed, then that point of time, the magnitude as well as you can see that the net work is remain same. So as a result, what we can see, the source is eliminated. Source may be eliminated now after combining both of them, and as a result, what we can see, EA and EB, they are together, while they are combined together, constituting a cycle or constitute a heat engine, constitute or together forms a heat engine, which operating in a cycle, obviously operating in a cycle, operating in a cycle, produces network. Network, how much network produced? Network produced WA minus WB, that amount of network is producing, and it is working, that is the actually violation, working with a single reservoir or single thermal reservoir, single thermal reservoir, because we have eliminated the source. Single thermal reservoir under sink only, sink is always there, it is working. And while we have started the Kelvin Planck statement, that point of time we have seen that heat engine cannot work for a single thermal reservoir. A source must be there and a sink must be there. Two thermal reservoir must be there. So that way, while we are now seeing that is working under a single thermal reservoir, actually that is violation of Kelvin Planck statement. So that way we are violating the Kelvin Planck statement, because we have eliminated a source, still that heat engine is working with a net work output. Okay, the heat is both of them, the heat flow and heat out, it is completely running fine, but it is not possible actually, because it is violating the Kelvin Planck statement. So that way, while it is violating the Kelvin Planck statement, why it is violating? Because you can see that one source we have eliminated, still it is running and it is not possible actually. So while we are violating the Kelvin Planck statement, then we can say that it is wrong actually, what we have assumed earlier, that eta Ea greater than eta Eb, it is now wrong, I can say. So hence, while it is violating, then we can say, now we can say that eta A greater than eta B, it is wrong. So if it is wrong, then the reverse one will be true. So the reverse one, that means eta B must be greater or greater than equal to eta A. That is a correct statement. Because while we are, firstly we have assumed that eta A is greater than eta B, and after assuming that one, finally while we combine both these heat engine, we have seen that it is actually violating the Kelvin Planck statement. So obviously, while it is violating the Kelvin Planck statement, then it is obviously, it is not true, it is wrong. So while it is wrong, then the reverse one will be true. So reverse one, obviously eta B must be greater than or greater than equal to with eta A. What does this mean? That means efficiency of a reversible heat engine must be greater than or equal to the irreversible heat engine. Basically, equal to, it never occurs, always occur greater than only. Always occur greater than the irreversible engine. Okay. So that is the whole proof of Carnot principle 1. Now we should go to the